Our first lesson describes the brain and the nervous system so that you get to know the physical structures that are responsible for music perception and emotion. Upcoming lessons will dive into what happens when music listening causes us to feel something in response. We will also look at individual differences and context, because even your favorite song can leave you unmoved if you hear it at the wrong time. For now, a neuroscience lesson. Let's start off with a quick tour of the brain. There are four major lobes called frontal, parietal, occipital, and temporal. At the base of the brain, joining it to the spinal cord, is the cerebellum. It is important for coordinating movement between the command center of the brain and the muscles of the body. The frontal lobe is where deciding, memorizing, learning, and other complex activities are carried out. We make judgments about music here. The parietal lobe is concerned with location and manipulation of objects out there in the world. It is important for performing music and moving in time with it. The occipital lobe receives visual information from the optic nerve bundle. The temporal lobe is where hearing takes place. Deep down inside the brain are nuclei that handle the most basic functions, including feelings and motivation. We hear through the cochlea, which convert acoustic pressure waves into complex patterns of nerve spike activity. The auditory nerve bundle exits each cochlea and travels up through the brainstem to arrive at the temporal lobe, just above our ears, where the primary auditory cortex resides. Along the way, nuclei in the brainstem do some crude pre-processing to establish where a sound is coming from and if it poses any danger. Danger signals bypass the frontal lobe and go straight to our muscles for making a quick escape. In the lower part of the frontal lobe is a region called Broca's area, named after the scientist who discovered that if this area is damaged on the left side of the brain, there will be problems with speaking. Just behind the primary auditory cortex is Wernicke's area, named for the scientist who discovered that damage here, again on the left side, causes problems with understanding speech. Fortunately for us, brains like to be efficient. We evolved to let regions in the left hemisphere handle linguistic tasks. Language demands an auditory cortex and frontal region that can make very fast judgments about sound. For example, telling someone to look out for bees calls for a very different kind of action than saying, look out for cheese. The sound difference between the bee and the sea is important. The sound of speech arrives rapidly, so the left side is our fast auditory processor. The same regions in the right hemisphere evolved to consider sound more slowly. In music, a single pitch means nothing important. Pitch needs time and other pitches to become a melody. So the right hemisphere is specialized for handling melody, harmony, and even rhythm perception. Damage to this area leaves speech abilities intact, but can harm music abilities, called amusia or tone deafness. All music is some combination of melody and rhythm, although some types of music can be just one or the other. In the next video, we will look at where rhythm is processed in the brain.